So Lovell, who do you fancy here, Ray, to win?
I think Toby Plenty will win, and he's been very successful this year on the European circuit, and he's England number two to the number one seed in this championship, Raj Youssef, and but he gets his own fair share of international scalps. He's got a particular style, in my opinion, that he's a very attacking, plays sharp angles, uses the net a lot, and puts huge pressure on his opponents. But I'm sure this Thomas that is playing against will be up to the task of making big rallies, but you're seeing there put huge pressure on Thomas there.
I hate to contradict you, Ray, but I think you said that Raj was the top seed. He's number four.
Is he? Sorry. Yes.
No, you're all right. You're all right.
Yeah.
I always like to correct.
I expected him to be the number one seed.
Yeah, well, I think his current ranking has dropped a little. And that's why he's only number four here.
He certainly won the championships before a few times.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that has surprised me, actually. That's a feature of Toby Plenty's game, those very tight shots to the sidelines, and very attacking. Really twists and turns the player.
That was a beautiful defensive shot he played there, Ray.
Certainly was, and his style makes the game very fast-paced. Always twisting and turning his opponent.
Very good net play there from both players, and just an unfortunate miss from Toby. That's just a slight drift left to right, just taking that out, no pace in the shuttle at all there. It's a very interesting battle at the moment, Ray.
The French boys certainly taking it on, and it could develop to a very interesting match.
Yeah,
I will stick with Penty as my man to win.
And I think in that last rally, the French lad served and just set himself up for the jump into the forehand corner, and Toby unfortunately played it straight up there. So he was on to the attack, and Toby was forced to defend from the word go. Same again there. Bad error from Toby. He just gives the Rouxel, the French lad, a very nice lead indeed at the moment, 9-3. So Toby will have to stop hitting the shuttle out at the moment. It's a battle of two styles. Toby's hitting it out and the French lad's hitting it in. But I'm sure that'll change because he's not the number six seed for nothing. He's obviously quality, he's just taking a little bit of time to get into his rhythm.
And so there's a 5-point difference, and often I will find that enormous in a match, but I've been watching this match very closely, and Thomas from France is putting a huge amount of work right in. And I feel Penty is just warming to the task.
So do you feel Penty's got plenty in the tank?
Yes, Dan. But also, as he wants the match to develop, Thomas Rouxel has put a lot of effort to get to this 10-4 and deserves to be 10-4 up. I just wonder how much he's taking out of himself.
Yeah, I did think myself he was... Well, that's a bad mistake from Toby again there. But I did think that the French lad was very... He was certainly motoring at the start of that match. Definitely up for it. But how long he can sustain the pace that he was playing at will remain to be seen. But Toby looks to be playing within himself, but he's just making too many unforced errors at the moment.
I'd say too far within himself at the moment. But look at that superb shot. That's more like the Toby that I know. And I'm sure it will come to light in this match.
The coach working with him, Ray? Do you know?
I don't. I was trying to spot that. My guess is it could be Stuart Waddell from England. Who had a spell as the English singles coach.
I just feel Toby needs to up the ante here, and he needs to get himself into a proper match frame where he's hitting the court, because if he doesn't and he keeps hitting the errors he's making at the moment, he's creating openings and then missing them, and that's another terrible shot there. So at the moment he's not doing his seeded position justice, and I hope he gets it back and can turn this around. Rouxel definitely is playing a lovely tight net at the moment. Toby's a very elegant... Oh, that was something different. A reverse from Rouxel. He's a very elegant mover, glides around the court as all good players do, but I think he's just needing to inject a little bit of pace into his game and hit the court.
And all the injection of pace is coming from Rouxel. But there's a long way to go in this match yet. And I don't feel a real pattern has developed besides Rouxel being on his game, Toby being off his game. And I think you've got to wait for Toby to come on stream. And apply a different level of pressure.
Not controlling the shuttle that well at the moment, but I did feel he had upped his pace a little there.
Yeah.
Which we think he has to do anyway, but he's got to be hitting the court and make his quality tell. Another one out. That's an unforced error, and it's not very characteristic of him, is it, Ray? He doesn't tend to do stuff like this.
The style of the rally that he's just played is characteristic of himself, but the number of errors that he's hitting isn't. And I think he's playing against a guy that's really on his game, and he's got a fight his way into the match, which I'm sure he's going to do. But it won't happen easily.
That's it. Lovely reverse from his forehand there. And Rouxel was forced to play it slightly higher, and Toby was quick enough to come in and play the kill.
Normally at 8-16 you'd say a player hasn't got a chance in winning the match because that's buffer of points has been made. But I still feel Toby's in this. 17-8, it starts to change a little bit.
Yeah, just before you said that, Ray, I was going to say it. I didn't think that the game had gone, the first set had gone from him, but it's going to be very difficult now. And I know it's only 1 point, but now it's two. From 16, it's now 18. The French lad only needs three, and Toby needs 13.
Yes.
And that's very difficult in men's singles.
And the rally point scoring is so unforgiving. Out as well.
But Toby's, he's, it's definitely a contrast in styles at the moment. The French lad hitting the court and Toby's hitting it out. And if that changes, then we will see the number 6 seed progress. But if not, he's looking at a very poor result for him. And me being a man that likes a challenge, I'm going to take the French boy to win the first set now at 20, game point 8 up. But this is very disappointing from Toby at the moment, so hopefully he'll get himself, his head sorted.
But I think you'll see a change in the second set, and it'll be a wake-up call and a fresh Toby that comes out onto court. Otherwise, he's out of the championships.
Yeah, but how would you explain this, Ray? You know, a player, the experience now that Toby's got, and he's come out here, and to me he looked as if he was in about third gear.
I agree.
And then he's got a little bit of a shock, and then he panics, and he's going for lines and making mistakes.
Yeah.
You know, he should have come out here ready for war from the word go and get the job done and get off. Save your energy.
Look, I totally agree with everything you said there, Dan. but not every day's the same for the player, and Toby is normally a 100% guy, and he's not firing on all cylinders at the moment, but he's got to find another gear, which I think personally he will, but I'm been wrong plenty of times before.
Never.
Yeah.
Don't believe it. See, this is what I expected. I expected to see the French player making the mistakes. Toby hitting the court, but there it's gone. So now they've got their work cut out in the English camp, and they've got to try and get his head right for the next game.
So Anthony Clark is with, I think that is Stuart Waddell. And his job now is to motivate Toby and get him up for the second game. And I've actually heard Anthony Clark say this in his 90 seconds before. It's that carry on like this and you're going out. So change it. And that's exactly what Toby's got to do now. Totally different demeanour from Imogen Bankier that came out. There was a spring in her step, and it's half the job done.
Yeah, I'm sure Imogen, as the coach in the French, is absolutely delighted there, the way that first set has gone. And as you say, it's the coach's job to try and get him up for it, and hopefully he's got the self-pride that he wants to get up for it, and we'll try and make the necessary changes to get the result he's looking for, and that's progress to the next round.
And what will make those changes is pace of the game. Toby's got to take the pace up, got to stop making the careless, unforced errors that he's been making, and bring a different pressure to bear on Thomas Rouxel. That's a beautiful cross defence. So a very workmanlike manner he's come out with, more determination. I agree with what Dan said. He's turned up late for work.
Just hope he can turn it round here. That wasn't out by all that much, and it was also a difficult shot because the shuttle from the French lad clipped the net cord, and he had to try and control it, and almost did.
Seen some lovely cross defence from Toby in this match already in the second set.
A little bit edgy still, I think, Ray.
Absolutely. He's not made a dent yet.
I think that's the French lad's favourite shot from his forehand, that cross slice. That's a nice shot.
Yeah.
Super shot there, the cross block.
Super shot.
Taken early and put Toby in trouble, and it wasn't a bad smash from Toby, but just within reach. The accuracy not just there, but the French lad took it in front of him and just crossed it very quickly. body language of Toby's not good at the moment.
It was different from the very start of the match, and 4-2 down, he's got to really get himself together and get that determination and push, because the early points are important when you've lost the first set like he has.
So 4-2 and one set to love up. Rouxel from France leads Toby Penty at the moment.
Rouxel is playing the net and hanging in. So he's expecting net replies from Toby, which is a feature of Toby's game.
So clearly they've done their homework, right?
Yeah. And these players would know each other well from playing the European circuit.
Good long rally this week.
Yeah.
Both players working hard. Think it'll take more out of the French lad. Yeah, very good. Eventually breaking down there, too flat, and Toby had the racket carriage to take it early and just turn it. Very good rally. I think that'll have damaged the French boy a little.
A little, but tactically, I'm seeing Rouxel hanging to the front of the court, and his base is forward, looking for the attack from Penty. But the actual opening is at the rear of the court, because Rouxel is taking it up the front of the court. Just a slight change in the pace of the match as well.
That was very nice. Just held it on the racket, just long enough for Toby to come up to the rear and play to the front. I'm sure Toby's not happy losing that point. Just a simple low serve and a reply. Didn't have to work for it.
Pace of this rally.
Yeah. And the French boy's been struggling all the time. If he wins this, he'll be absolutely delighted. Oh, he should have hit that. Lovely shot from Toby just to turn it. Well,
yeah.
Left. I'm watching where that shuttle's on the monitor. I see it on the court, but I think it's in, but called out.
Tight call.
Yeah, and but well left. Well left from Toby.
And the pace of that rally was high.
Silly mistake. I just feel he's not firing in all cylinders at the moment.
Yeah. that's him.
That was a lovely shot, because I think the French lad was looking for the cross cut from his forehand there. And Toby just hit the straight clear. He looked a little bit as if his body weight was going forward, and Toby hit the shot.
No, I think you're exactly right, Dan. Toby's got a particular style of play that's likes to play the net, and Thomas Rouxel is looking for it all the time.
Yeah, and it's obviously the player is in control, and it's their job to try and get the solutions to the problems, but surely the coaches behind the court where he can see this as well. I mean, the chap played across net and he almost stood at the net and, you know, waiting on the net reply. So they should be saying to Toby, maybe they are, maybe he just can't change, he likes to play the net.
He's got an effective style of play, and these types of players like Thomas Rouxel would know it, but it's whether they can break it down. So the real opening on the Frenchman's side now is at the rear of the court.
Yeah, and Toby's got to use that. That's it. That's what he should be doing. The occasional net shot to keep the French guy thinking that he's going to play his normal style of game and just flick it over him.
And then slip into his most effective style.
Yep.
You could have been a coach, Dan. I should have been.
Oh, he's hit another one out. But we've got all the answers from up here. It's dead easy up here. We've got the height. We can hit with angle from up here. We've got every shot in the book.
That's a feature of top-class men's singles now that you see a lot, is playing to virtually centre of the net to cut down the angles.
I sense the French lad's getting a little slower, and it's maybe taking a bit too much out of him, trying to play at the pace he was playing all the time, hunting the front.
But 10-9, Dan, it's a tight way to play a game.
Yeah, it is, but I think it's changed. That's the shot. That's his favourite shot. And it's a lovely shot. It's a lovely shot. It was so nice. Toby was admiring it there. But it was very deceptive. That's me being disrespectful.
So stop it.
All right. I am scolded.
That's a great shot.
Yep. Well, I thought it changed, Ray, but I'm now not so sure.
But look at the way he got that point. A smash at Toby's body. And that's the way to go. He's got to get aggressive now, the French boy. That's a superb cross. That was tight.
That's a cut just to finish it there. It just clipped the net tape on the way over as well. It was a fantastic shot. That's the one you were on about, Ray.
Yeah.
The smash at the body.
So effective. Because they've got nowhere to go. If they smash either side, they can go behind their body to get it. But when it's at the body, you're under huge pressure. That's tight net from Toby there.
Yeah. And it's such tight net, it's amazing that he got it to the rear of the court and lifted out.
Oh. That's the way for this French boy, is to go heavy on his attack. But one point I'd like people to... Toby's using short serves. Look how far up the court the Frenchman is standing. Right, looking for that forecourt. That's a nice shot. He's hanging on that net all the time, the Frenchman. That's a superb shot.
Was a chance for him there.
But now we're at the stage of the rally where it would be difficult to do an all-out attack because they're so spent in the rally.
I just felt his net shot was so tight that he had lots of time to try and get under it. But as you say, Ray, the legs were tiring there as he went back and he just hit the clear. But it was a good length clear, so Toby's to do a lot of work to get behind that also. But it's a tense situation now for Toby. He's lost the first 21-11. He's 13-11 down. I don't think he'll be comfortable. I think he'll be... He won't quite have hit the panic button yet, but...
But it could happen.
It could, yes.
And it becomes so difficult to play an open game and a rear court game when you're in this tense situation. You don't want to give the shuttle away. You don't win to give options to your opponent.
Yep. And I was just saying, I don't think he's hit the panic button, but I think he's reaching for it at the moment.
I agree. But it still can all change.
Yeah, he's a good enough player. He could very easily just turn this round. But let's hope he can do so. That's a lovely shot there. Again, he was looking for the front of the court.
Absolutely.
Change direction.
And the openings are...
And he's left that. That's so... I'm now... He's firmly got a finger on the panic button and he's pressed it because that was hopeful, that lead there. And that's on the side where the drift would just take it out.
Next up, on court number four, from Canada, Rachel Hunter.
15-11, so we better get really focused now. No room for unforced errors here. This French chap is going to go for it, I think.
Yeah, and that's the right thing to do. And... That's a great shot.
That's a lovely shot too. It's nice from Auba. That's the panic button. It's now blaring. Toby's got to get it back together now.
That's not a positive look in his face, Dan.
No. Oh, the French lad was looking for that lift there. That's a nice shot. Something different at this stage in the game and the confidence to play it.
Oh, what a shot.
That's been a cross net for me, so effective. He takes it in the backhand side, so you're looking for the lift up his forehand. And he's got a little bit of luck there, but he deserved that. Some lovely stuff in that rally. Over to Yuri.
No, I agree, and it's a commentator's choice, so he can change sides. I'm not actually going to. I'm going to stick with Penty, which is very brave.
Yeah. Yeah, the England coach is telling them there, come on, get the legs working. It's going to get tough here. That's it. And he's looking for everything early. That's the second one. He's just had a little jump and taken it early on his forehand, putting the French lad under pressure.
But he put him under pressure at the back, and it's hard to do at this stage of the game, but that's exactly what he's got to do.
That's the difference in the first set there. That shuttle would have gone out, the big smash, but he's kept it in, dictating the rally, keeping the Frenchman doing a lot of work, and he's on to everything early.
And they are into the physical area of the game. The worry I've got for Penty here is he's got this particular style, and a lot of the times he's playing to that style, and that's what Thomas Rouxel is reading.
Oof. That was a superb smash.
Yeah.
17-14.
And he's going big.
Next on court, number 5, Victor Spencer.
Look how far Penty is up the court.
Yeah.
Oh, that was well left. Well left.
I felt that was a nervous leaf.
Well, it may have been Ray, but he's judged it right anyway.
But it's 15-17. I'd far rather be on the 17.
Yes. Because all the pressure's on Toby at the moment.
The French boy was... Yeah, but he was hanging in there.
Yeah, I think it's all turned now. I think the French lad, as you say, was going big. He was going to look for winners.
But he still can.
Take chances.
He still can. A few at the body. Yeah, but look how far up the court he is now.
Oh, that's a gift. That's a gift at this stage. 18-16.
As I've said all along, I think Penty should win this match, but all credit to Thomas Rouxel, because that's a big shot I'm talking about. He's got to go big and look for the front.
Yeah, he's certainly doing that. But of course, in doing that, Ray does leave himself open to lifts over.
And using more energy.
Yep. Toby's lifting to him. And that's what he's looking for. Now he's not, which is good. Got to get these lifts accurate, because this boy's going for it now.
Absolutely. Good bit of deception. Oh, that, what a shot.
Lovely shot. That is real quality there.
He needed a few more of those in this match.
Still under lots of pressure.
Yeah. There's a 2-point buffer. And I've got to be honest with... I was Thomas Rouxel, I'd look at getting the lift and going for Toby's body and really forcing the front of the court.
So you would hit at him and really hunt the front, Ray?
Hunt the front.
Charge forward.
Absolutely, yeah. And I'd try and hit him on his right side of his body. Right pocket.
Boy, he snatched at that. Now, I think it could be all over 2017. It's not He just needs 3 wins, 3 points, but he's not had a run of 3 points, yeah. I don't think, at any stage in the game. But
we both know where our money is now.
Yeah. Certainly with the French chap. Oh, it was in. Rouxel, he was hoping it was out. But I think the drift just comes left to right. That would just have held that shuttle in. So, but one mistake and Toby's out.
That's a smash at the body. And at the present, I think the French boy's playing it right. Smash at the body.
Oh. Now 19.
It was always going to get like this. And now it's scrappy and it's anyone's.
Mm-hmm. You'd still rather be in the French boy's shoes because he's got the first set in the bag.
I'd be looking for that body, but really hunting the net. And that's using up a lot of the energy. If it goes to a third, then who's your money on?
Oh, Toby.
Yeah,
Toby.
Absolutely.
Oh! That's the one he beat him with earlier in this set.
Yeah.
Just served low at the start. And Toby's Scottish Open is over. I don't think he'll be too happy at that loss.
No, but all credit to the Frenchman, Thomas Rouxel. Superb performance, superb tactics. He's done brilliant.
Yeah, played very, very well. 21-11, 21-19, and he moves into the quarterfinals. So he'll have plenty of time to recover. So unfortunately, England's Toby Penty is now out of the tournament. One of the seeds to fall today. It was a very good performance from Rouxel. France, very attacking, hunting the front of the court to force the lift, and then when the lift came, moving very quickly to get behind it. That was a feature of the game, his cross-court cut from his forehand. Toby just not firing on all cylinders today for some reason.
The
Frenchman's net play was very, very good.
And his winner.
Just a little break of the wrist there to send that shot cross court and send them into the next round.